Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Hello students, welcome to Swayam Prabha. The course title is Principles of Marketing and the lecture title is Developments in Marketing Part 2. This is Module 15, Lecture 1. I am Dr. Shoma Singupta, Associate Professor Commerce, Kamala Nehru College, University of Delhi. In this module, we will cover two topics: social marketing concept, tools and issues, digital marketing concept, tools and issues. In this first lecture, we will cover the first topic, that is social marketing concept, tools and issues. Concept of social marketing. We know that product is anything which can be offered to the market and it includes goods, services and ideas. Like the marketing of goods and services, the ideas can also be marketed, and ideas normally, usually it includes any drive to change the behavior of the targeted customers or target audience. We can say target audience. Now, social marketing is a strategy for changing behavior. So when we are wishing to change the behavior of people, like we want to propagate some good habits in the market or targeted audience, then we can again create a marketing mix as we create a marketing mix for marketing of products and services. Now, the problem with all the social ideas, marketing of social ideas, is that generally the campaigns, they focus only on one of the P's, and that is promotion. While for marketing of ideas, again, all the P's are important. So social marketing means the design, implementation and control of programs seeking to increase the acceptability of social idea or practice in a target group or groups. This is given by Kotler. Social marketing is the program planning process that promotes the voluntary behavior of target audiences by offering benefits they want, reducing barriers they are concerned about, and using persuasion to motivate their participation on program activity. So this definition is given by Kotler and Roberto. Social marketing is the design, implementation and control of programs calculated to influence the acceptability of social ideas as involving consideration of product, planning, communication, distribution and marketing research. And this is given by Kotler and Zaltman. So in nutshell, what we have understood, like the marketing of goods and services, in case of marketing of ideas or while you want to change the behavior of the target audience, we have to use all the principles of marketing and we have to create or plan a marketing mix suitable for the propagation of that campaign. Continuing with the concept of social marketing, we can say that social marketing deals with social change and social benefits, ethical values and upliftment of the society, attitudinal and behavioral change, educating the masses to overcome the malpractices inherent in the society. So most of the time we find that social marketing deals with social causes. Now, social marketing is the systematic application of marketing along with other concepts and techniques to achieve specific behavioral goals for a social good. Now, it utilizes the concepts of market segmentation, consumer research, product concept, development and testing, directed communication, facilitation, incentives and exchange theory to maximize the target adopter's response. So we can say that it is exactly like marketing of goods and services, that we have to do all this market segmentation and positioning and concept, product concept development, and developing the marketing mix. Features of social marketing. The primary aim of social marketing is, as we have discussed, social good. While in commercial marketing, the aim is primarily financial. So here we are fighting for a cause. We want acceptability of certain ideas. Social marketing is being described as having two parents. One is the social parent, that is the social sciences and social policy. And then there is a marketing parent, which is the commercial aspect or public sector marketing approaches. It has matured into much more integrative and inclusive discipline that draws in the full range of social sciences and social policy approaches as well as marketing. So that's why we can say two parents are there, that is social and marketing. Social marketing applies a consumer-oriented approach and uses the concepts and tools used by commercial marketers in pursuit of social goals, like anti-smoking campaigns, fundraising for NGOs or anything, AIDS awareness, family planning campaign. In India, we have a very successful polio vaccination campaign. It also requires application of integrated marketing and concept of 4 P's, that is product, price, promotion, and place or distribution. And there are certain other P's also, 4 additional P's are there in the marketing mix of social goods, and that is public, partnership, policy, and purse string, which we will discuss in detail later on. Application of social marketing. Now, social marketing can be applied to promote merit goods or social goods that make the society avoid demerit goods, and thus to promote that considers society's well-being as a whole. So this is for changing the behavior of the target audience for their own good, for the goodness of themselves, and for doing good to the society. So areas where it has been used are anti-tobacco campaigns, family planning, AIDS awareness about breast cancer, cervical cancer, environmental issues, organ donation and blood donation, polio vaccination, safe driving, say no to plastic bags, and the causes may be innumerable. And for that, you can have social marketing campaign. Like in one country, a simple concept like they were moving from right hand drive to left hand drive or left hand drive to right hand drive. So there also, again, there is a need for change in behavior, and social marketing was utilized there. Types of social marketing. Now, the social marketing can be for different causes and can be initiated by different institutions, and on the basis of that, we can categorize the social marketing campaigns. It can be organizational when a drive or anything is any idea, any social behavior is initiated by universities, government and non-governmental organizations, cooperative bodies. So we can say that these are organizational social marketing campaigns. It can be people based, like it can be in for individuals, or it can be even in for individual, it can be for political candidates when they want to promote their candidature among the public, then also they can have this social marketing campaign. It can be idea based, very popularly in India, family planning, AIDS awareness, polio vaccination campaign. So these are idea based, but some worked, some didn't in India, and the reason behind it is that we haven't created a program according to the concepts of social marketing. This can be service based also, like community services. So that can also be considered as a type of social marketing. First of all, there should be consumer orientation, which is a must. A consumer orientation or need identification to realize organizational or social goals is important. Second, influence action. The ultimate objective of marketing is to influence action, and same is the case in case of social marketing. Focus is on target audience. Action is undertaken whenever target audiences believe that the benefits they receive will be greater than the cost they incur. So a cost-benefit analysis is going on in the minds of the target audience, and you have to make them realize that the benefits are much, much higher than the cost involved. Exchange is critical. Programs to influence action will be more effective if they are based on an understanding of the target audience's own perception of the proposed exchange. So in a way, it is supporting the previous point that that exchange, that is the value exchange, which is going on in the mind, it is important to understand that. Segment markets, target audiences are seldom uniform, you know that, in their perception and likely responses to marketing efforts. And so they should be segmented and partitioned likewise, so that you can identify a segment to whom you are focusing attention on, and also derive a marketing strategy for that segment, for catering to that segment. Further, design an integrated marketing mix using the 8 P's that we have discussed. Monitor and be flexible. Time to time, you have to monitor your program. Management must be prepared to rapidly alter the strategies and tactics whenever it is required. Control is important. A process tracking system with both integrative and control function. And finally, manage. That is a management process that involves problem analysis, planning, implementation, and feedback functions. So these are the essentials of social marketing. Dimensions of social marketing. Socially responsible business policies such as green marketing, non-polluting units, corporate social responsibilities, these can be achieved with the help of social marketing. Like, I'll take one example, like green marketing. Through green marketing, you are marketing greener products, that is environment friendly products. So most of the time there is a condition that these green products are either difficult to procure or they are expensive. So, and or people are more habituated to using non-green products. So through social marketing campaigns, you can change the behavior pattern of the target audience so that they can accept that green products. Like LED is a green product, but it is expensive. So many of the people will not be ready to take up that product because it is expensive. So through social marketing, you can make them understand that how this is beneficial for them, or how it will be cost effective for them in near future or in long run. And also it is environment friendly. So you can make a change with the help of the marketing mix. Applicability of marketing philosophy and principles to the introduction of ideas and issues of social significance, like road safety, AIDS awareness, family planning, which we have discussed earlier also. Process of social marketing begins with problem definition. Now, there is some gap in the market in the sense that there are certain environmental or social issues which are not yet popular among the targeted audiences, or they haven't accepted it. So you have to find out what is the problem related to that issue. Then you have to set the goals. So goal setting is the next step, and whereby you will set a goal which you want to achieve, in the sense that you want to, say, change the behavior of the target audience. So that becomes the goals regarding a particular issue. Then market segmentation. Now, you know that the total market is very big and you want to introduce this change in a particular segment only. So on the basis of various criteria like geographic or demographic or psychographic, you will segment the market, and then only you can select a particular segment in which you want to introduce the change. Then customer analysis, that is within that segment, you will analyze the behavior and perceptions of the customer. So that is the next step. Developing marketing strategies. Now you know the profile of the customer or the target audience, we can say, because they are actually target audience. So you can create a marketing strategy and a marketing mix accordingly. And accordingly, you have to think about what will be included in product, how will you price, promote, place, what will be the budget of the campaign, the public, and also the policy makers. You have to include them. Partnerships have to be created. So all the 8 P's you have to take care of here. Then comes implementation. Now you have whatever marketing mix or marketing strategy you have derived, you have to implement it and then review and feedback time to time to find out whether we are going in the right direction or my program is bringing me the results. There is a behavioral change and it is a sustained permanent behavioral change. So that you have to find out. And if not, then you have to make changes in the program. Developing social marketing strategies or marketing mix. As we have discussed that there are 8 P's of marketing mix in case of social marketing. So social marketing mix consists of 8 P's, the 4 traditional ones and 4 additional ones. The traditional P's of marketing mix, that is product strategy, price, promotion and place. 4 additional P's of social marketing are public, partnership, policy and posturing. So we will discuss each of these P's in detail in the next few slides. Product. Now a product is something which has the ability to satisfy the consumer's needs and wants. So you know about that. And product strategies are needed in social marketing as well. So when we talk about product like goods and services, in case of goods, it is tangible, and in case of services, though intangible, but it can be felt, and the customer derives benefit out of it immediately. But when we talk about idea as a product, it is shapeless, intangible, as well as there is no immediate benefit of that behavioral change. So here this problem is there to give a shape to the product. That is the campaign. That is the idea. So characteristic of a product is public goods, where government agencies are the marketer. Public at large are direct consumers, as they are affected by consumption of these goods. They are purchased in exchange of price of taxation is there. Meritorious public goods are also there. Merit goods, we call them. They are produced at considerable cost but offered at a notional price, such as education, healthcare. The social marketing product is not necessarily a physical offering. There can be a component of physical offering, but it is in totality is not a physical offering. A continuum of product exists, ranging from tangible physical products like in case of family planning campaign, condoms are the physical offering. Then services like medical examination is a service which is a part of, say, AIDS awareness campaign. Practices like breastfeeding, ORS enucleation, eating a heart healthy diet, all these are practices which are also social goods. Intangible ideas like environmental protection, say no to plastic bags, this is an intangible idea. Now, in order to have a viable product, people must first perceive that they have a genuine problem and that the product offering is a good solution for that problem. So most important is that they have to understand that there is a genuine problem. Now, why family planning campaign is not successful in India? Because the strata of society doesn't believe that this will be beneficial for them if they have lesser number of children. Because for them, every additional children is actually two helping hands in future to earn money. So they are not understanding that it is creating a population problem. So that making them understand is the first step, and then for that the campaign may be programmed. So in social marketing, what should be the product strategy? Now, it includes branding, packaging, product positioning and product differentiation. as is the case with product, and product differentiation, as is the case with product. Here, a social marketer encounters three major problems. They tend to have less flexibility in shaping their product or offering. They have more difficulty in formulating product concept because it is an idea, just an idea. They have greater difficulty in selecting and implementing long-term positioning strategies. So these problems are there while creating the product strategy. So the primary focus is on the consumer, on learning what people want and need, rather than trying to persuade them to buy what we happen to be producing. The role of research here is to discover the consumer's perception of the problem and the product, and to determine how important they feel it is to take action against the problem. Package the social idea in such a way that it is desirable and people are willing to purchase it. Sellers have to create a tangible product which is both viable and helps promote our main social objective. The social marketer must define the change sought, which may be a change in values, beliefs, effects or behavior. So this is the most difficult part of the social marketing mix, that is giving a shape to an idea to sell it like a product. The second P of marketing mix you are well aware of. You know that the price refers to what the consumer do or is ready to pay to obtain the social marketing product. In social terms, the marketer's approach should be to increase the rewards for buying the product relative to the cost. So this is one aspect. So you have to improve the reward. We have discussed about the trade-off which goes on in the minds of the targeted audience. Here, additionally, there are problems in case of pricing. Although you know that many a times the cost of manufacturing the social idea or the product related to social idea is borne by the government. So absolutely in free terms, it is given to the target audience, as is the case of polio vaccination. But there are psychological costs involved in case of these social campaigns. So we will discuss that now. So the characteristics are, the cost here are of two types: monetary, the price of the social product, which is minuscule in many cases, psychological, that is to give up the intangible such as time or effort, or to risk embarrassment and disapproval. Now, why family planning campaign is not successful? One of the reasons is that the marketers haven't identified the psychological cost or price associated with this thing, that is the embarrassment, disapproval, or using of contraceptives. So these are fears, and psychological fears are there. So you have to hit the psychological fears also while pricing. So it is not only just reducing the price or giving it free of cost to the target audience, but it is about monitoring the psychological cost and trying to reduce it. If the costs outweigh the benefits for an individual, the perceived value of the offering will be low and it will be unlikely to be adopted. If the benefits are perceived as greater than their cost, chances of trial and adoption of the product is much greater. Coming to the price strategy in case of social marketing, if the product is priced too low or provided free of charge, we believe that acceptability will be higher, but the consumer may perceive it as being low in quality. If the price is too high, some will not be able to afford it, and then the campaign will flop. Social marketers must balance these considerations and often end up charging at least a nominal fee to increase perceptions of quality and to confer a sense of dignity to the transaction. These perceptions of costs and benefits can be determined through research and used in positioning of the product. Social marketers should try to reduce the psychological price or non-monetary price. Facilitators and creation of positive environment is required for that. Reducing the time and effort to be put in to adopt the idea, that is very important. And one of the example is in case of polio vaccination campaign, the psychological cost of taking the kid to the hospital to get the inoculation done, that psychological fear was there, time, effort, taking a leave from job. These problems were there, and the campaigners, they have hit this issue. So this polio vaccination campaign is run on weekends, that is Sunday, and the centers from where you can get polio vaccination are nearest to the targeted audience. So if it may be a school which is nearest to that house, and or it can be, and even if you are traveling in metro cities, metro stations, in railway stations, airports, everywhere the volunteers are there. So this is reducing the psychological cost or pressure of the on the target audience, and of course it is given free of cost. So that's why it is becoming, it has turned out to be a success. Third element is promotion. Promotion aims to disseminate information or promote an idea, and consists of integrated use of all the tools of promotion, and that you can use in social marketing as well: advertising, public relations, promotions, media advocacy, personal selling, entertainment vehicles. Because of its visibility, most of the time what we find that this element, that is promotion, is mistakenly thought of as comprising the whole of the social marketing. So in most of the campaigns, they are actually spending on promotion only. Say when we talk about donate your eyes, and this is you must be knowing that the endorser is Aishwarya Rai, who has the most beautiful pair of eyes. But the problem is that they are focusing only on promotion, and people have so much of psychological fear that nobody is going for actually donating eyes or signing up for eye donation or say organ donation. So we can only know about, we know about all these just because of the promotion, but what about the other piece? So that is the problem, and that is the problem with family planning also. For years they ran different commercials and promotion campaigns, but they didn't focus on price and distribution and all other piece. Nevertheless, promotion is important in case of social marketing, and we have to create a well-drafted promotion strategy to popularize an idea. Now, promotion campaign should play more of an educating role rather than just informing role. Communication persuasion strategy, which will make the product or cause familiar, acceptable and desirable to the audience, should be created. It should reduce the psychological fears or costs. So in promotion also, time and again, you will hit the psychological costs or fears. Research is crucial to determine the most effective and efficient vehicle to reach the target audience. Now, you know that different means of promotion or promotion tools is used for disseminating the information. Most of the time, you are finding advertising on media, television and newspaper. But there are other ways also, like to remind people that this is the polio vaccination day for the month. You see different kind of promotion tools are used beside the radio announcement and television announcements, and putting advertisements in newspaper. You will find that there are certain gas balloons with yellow colored, and in which the date of polio vaccination campaign day is written on that in the vicinity of different societies. So people traveling, going here, there, they can look into that balloon and that will remind. And of course, those people who with little kids, they will definitely see those balloons. This increase demand and gain publicity at media events and in news stories. So this can also be another way. Methods include public service announcements or paid ads, coupons, special displays, premiums, editorials, programs and media events like Tupperware style parties or displays also take place to disseminate this information. Use of celebrities like film stars, sports personalities increase the chance of receptiveness by the target audience. Now, when we again talk about successful polio vaccination campaign, you know that the main endorser is Amitabh Bachchan, who is in the heart of every Indian, and so the acceptability of whatever he says is more, especially in rural and suburban areas. So that's why the campaign all the more becomes successful. Everybody will remember the slogan which is spoken by Amitabh Bachchan, and that is Do Boon Zindagi Ke. So everybody will remember, and they will the acceptability of the idea is more. The fourth important P of marketing mix is space or distribution. Place describes the way the product reaches the consumer, which includes, you know, channel of distribution and distribution mode and vehicle. Characteristics are, for an intangible product, place is less clear cut, refers to decisions about channels through which consumers are reached with information or training. In case of social marketing, it can be doctors' offices, shopping malls, mass media vehicles, in-home demonstrations, even the RWAs, that is the resident welfare associations. They can be a mode of distribution, ensuring accessibility of the offering and quality of the service delivery. Place strategy. So research to determine ideal means of distribution for the offering is required to determine the activities and habits of the target audience, determine their experience and satisfaction with the existing delivery system, adequate distribution of idea through devoted volunteers and NGOs, community opinion leaders can be used extensively, RWAs. For intangible products, traditional channels are used, like retail outlets, hospitals, door-to-door distribution. Motivated person should know where the product can be obtained from. Planning in this field involves development of appropriate accessible outlets, their size, locations, giving motivation to the outlets or volunteers to perform their parts of job. Now coming to the additional P's which are used in social marketing campaigns is the one that is public strategy. Social marketers often have many different audiences that their program has to address in order to be successful. Public refers to both the external and internal groups involved in the program. External publics include target audience, secondary audiences, policymakers, and gatekeepers who restrict the information. The internal publics are those who are involved in some way with either approval or implementation of the program. Generating a positive attitude among the public to accept the idea and provide support for its spread among the members of the society. Next additional element is partnership. So the partnership strategy has to be derived. Social and health issues are often so complex that one agency can't make a dent by itself. So there is a requirement of partnership between all the stakeholders. So partnership should be encouraged between the stakeholders. Team up with other organizations in the community to really be effective. Find out which organizations have similar goals, and identify ways to work together. Build partnership through gaining support and acceptance of those who will be affected by the campaign and the implementation agencies. Next element is policy. Social marketing programs can do well in motivating individual behavior change, but that is difficult to sustain unless the environment they are in supports that change for the long run. So the government, if it comes out with a clear-cut policy which supports a campaign, then it will become more effective and the acceptability will be more. The central and state government should come out with a clear-cut policy regarding the social good. Here I will take an example of the Say No to Plastic Bags campaign. And you see that the policy of the government is required. When policy of government supports, the ruling of the government supports that cause, then acceptability is more, of course, it helps in it. Although in long run, when there is leniency on the part of the government, then the campaign fails. That happened in case of Say No to Plastic Bag campaign. As I was telling you that for permanent behavioral change, social marketing is more important rather than rules and regulations. But initially the rules and regulations, they support the campaign, and it should remain always so that a permanent behavioral change can take place among the people. Often policy change is needed and media advocacy programs can be an effective complement to a social marketing program. The eighth and the last P is purse string. You know that for running a campaign, we need a lot of funds, and who will provide that fund? So we have to mop up the funds from different sources, and that is purse string. If sufficient fund is not there, the campaigns, they fail. Later on, the campaigns, they fail because of paucity of the funds. So most organizations that develop social marketing programs operate through funds provided by sources such as foundations, government grants and donations, donations from NGOs, that is non-governmental organizations, international organizations like United Nations Development Program, UNDP is promoting many of the social campaigns. Strategy needs to be developed to mop up funds for the campaign from different agencies. To summarize this lecture, we can say social marketing is the design, implementation and control of programs seeking to increase the acceptability of social idea or practice in a target group. Social marketing may be initiated organizational, people-based, idea-based or service-based. So who is initiating is or what is the purpose, on the basis of that the types of social marketing can be identified. The process of social marketing involves problem definition, goal setting, market segmentation, customer analysis, developing marketing strategies, implementation, review and feedback. Social marketing mix consists of blending of the four P's of marketing mix, that is product, price, promotion and place, and the four additional P's which are used in social marketing, like public, partnership, policy and purse string. Thank you very much, students. So this was Developments in Marketing Part 2, Module 15, Lecture 1.